Cool. You know, for more than a decade, Honolulu Magazine has been publishing a chart that ranks Hawaii's public schools. Now, an in-depth report dives into the Department of Education math reading scores and surveys, along with a few other issues. Now, editor Robbie Dingeman joins us right here to take a look at the magazine, this issue. And I love your guys' magazine. It's been, you know, a fixture in Honolulu from over a century. I mean, yeah. A long, long time. And again, I love reading it, but this is probably one of your more popular annual issues because of this. Talk about this ranking system. How did you guys come up with this and all the things that go into it?
Well, first, thank you so much for having us.
Oh, no problem.
It's a pleasure. The grading the public schools issue is a really important one for many people in the community because, you know, we all want to know about the schools in our mm-hmm. community. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm a product of Hawai'i Public Schools, mm-hmm. Kalaheo.
Nice.
You know, so. But I think it's important to look at the school scores, look at the different, because you know in different neighborhoods you know you have some options mm-hmm, and you do mm-hmm. want to know if you're a parent, if you're even, you know, an auntie, if Put you're on, your yep. neighbors, mm-hmm, you know, mm-hmm. you name it. And so what we think it's important to do is show the snapshot of the elementary schools, the middle schools, and the high schools for public schools, and we look at the various factors, and it gives you an idea of where they are. And it shows you the schools that are up and coming, mm-hmm. and it shows you sometimes the schools that have been consistently excellent. So it's not to diss the schools.
Oh, no, not at all.
That are, mm-hmm. It's just to give people an idea, because we know it's a tool, and it's important.
Oh, it's a useful tool. I know so many people that talk about your issue and utilizing it. I love, though, how you use not only the DOE numbers in education, but you guys do surveys, parents. I mean, there's so many other formats and things that come into this whole issue in regards to that.
Yes, mm-hmm. the ranking itself for the past 2 years, this year and last year, come from the Department of Education mm-hmm. and their scores. And then we've dived into other things. So, for example, we have a longer piece about teacher evaluations because that's something that people are really mm-hmm. interested in. How are the teachers doing? How are they helping our kids? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So we have a good piece by our experienced education writer, Lauren Moreno, dived into that. And then we also had Mary Borsino talking to some top teachers about ways that everyone can get along better in the schools for students, tips, things that they've learned over the years.
So parents can really get a lot of information, not only the schools, but you know, how to help their kiki and when they go into the transition from middle school to high school or elementary, vice versa.
Yes, because I mean, we know there's issues in the school, but mm-hmm. we also know there are a lot of successes.
And, you know, and speaking of success, I love your magazine. Just gets bigger and better. And you not only have about the schools, the interviews, picks around town, what to do in April. What are fun things that we also can get in this month's issue?
Well, one of the really things we're so happy about and so proud of in this issue also is a piece we did on homelessness. And I know it's a tough issue, but we have a good piece about the people in homeless in Honolulu and what those issues are. Again, Mary Borsino suited mm-hmm. up for that one. And then we're also really proud of something different. It's a piece by Diana Kim mm-hmm. in here, and she's a local photographer.
Yes, great photographer.
And mm-hmm. she found out that her estranged dad was homeless and on
My
the
goodness.
Street. She tracked him down, and she tells the story here in pictures. Mm-hmm. And happily, you'll see at the end of the piece, I don't want to spoil it, but you'll see at the end of the piece, he got some help, and he's doing much better.
That's
and
wonderful.
So it's a really inspiring story.
You know, I love it. I just opened up. I mean, the pictures and the print that tell the story of it, homeless initiatives, everybody knows about, and the way that you guys approach it is so respectful and understanding. But I got to say, these pictures, you know, they say a picture is worth 1,000 words, but it is amazing the story that tells in these pictures. I mean, as an editor, I mean, is that difficult? Is that challenging? Is that a unique goal to be able to tell a story that way?
It really is. I mean, it's the advantage of a magazine is we can show the pictures so much better. I mean, I've worked in newspapers mm-hmm. and television, and I love each. But something about a magazine, you know, you can take it to the beach, you can take it, you can save it, you can look through it all, you can come back and reread the parts that were most meaningful to you. So mm-hmm. we felt happy with the mix. We do try for a mix in every issue.
Yes.
And mm-hmm. we also, you know, like the third segment in a new show, we also have some lighter side things.
And talk about that, because you went on something that's really cool, and especially for someone like me with a sweet tooth. What do you got that's kind of rounding it all up at the end of the magazine?
Well, Catherine Toth Fox mm-hmm. headed out on the street for us, and she went to Kaimuki, where there are so many sweet spots mm-hmm. in that two-street area from 12th Avenue and Waialae. Mm-hmm. And there's so many things, right? There's Sconi's, which has been there forever. There's Via Gelato. There's chocolate vanilla, the chocolate pyramid.
Yeah, Auto Cake is
Auto
right
cake.
There.
Oh,
everything's
Auto's
so
amazing.
Good. And Kat is so great the way she writes, but to have that in Kaimuki, it's so nice to have that local flavor with so many desserts in that area.
It is, and Kat did such a great job. She went into the history and the news things and the individual stories. I mean, Otto, she couldn't reach him for a while because he was at the Academy Awards.
Yeah, he's a busy guy. He's a busy
right?
guy. Well, speaking of busy, thank you for taking the time to talk with us. And again, a great issue, Honolulu Magazine, one of their popular issues with the annual rankings, but all the cool stuff in there as well. You want to definitely check it out.